Welcome to, or welcome back to, the Lug and Tug Sawmill. If you're new here and you like what you see, remember to hit that like and subscribe buttons. We really appreciate your help. The sapwood on this old chestnut oak was already rotten, but it was still kind of hard to get the bark to peel. Thinking of trying something different, maybe a hammer drill with a big wide blade on it. I don't know, anybody got any other ideas? There's Brad's Polaris Ranger there at the top of the screen. He stopped by, visited a few minutes this afternoon. I don't know why I do this. I know you can't back out of a cut without wedging the thing up so it won't bind on the blade. Luckily, I didn't destroy this band. It'll just need to be reset and resharpened. It was a stupid mistake anyway. There's a piece of bark on the track on my side. I should have seen it in a heartbeat.
Putting the blade back on, making two or three attempts to get it leveled out, had to change the blade. So now we're going to see if we can make a level cut this time.
Carol did the check. It looks like we're flat and level this time. We'll finish the log. The hickory stick really comes in handy on this log. It's not really that big, but it's heavy. If I didn't have the hickory stick, I'd have to use some kind of a jack to lift it up and get it leveled. No, I don't drink and saw. I'm just clumsy. And if I didn't have cat-like reflexes, I'd have been on my face. In the sawdust. Took a little shave cut off here just to be sure that everything's still flat. Well, you've made it to the halfway mark. How about hitting the thumbs up and the subscribe button? That cant didn't come out exactly square. I had to stick a little wedge under it to make the sides square with the top square with the sides. I'm going to turn this one over. That'll make it square on the sides too. Got a few boards to edge and then we'll be done. Maybe one of them will give us two 2x6s. Thank you. Thanks so much for stopping by. We hope you enjoyed your visit. Come back and see us again.